Actually, as VUBA is down almost 8% now, it tried to move higher and failed. A stock that is down 8% is not likely to continue higher. You want to see the buyers getting out of the game, and you can see them in the first 2 1-minute candles here. So I'm looking for a reversal in order to short it. However, take a look at the spread between the buyers and the sellers, 67.02, 67.23. We've got like a 20-cent spread right now. And it's quite dangerous. If it moves down under 67, I'm going to short it, 2,000 shares now. Just move down under 67, I'm short 2,000 shares. My regular quantity is higher than 2,000. It's just that because of the spread, I trust it a little bit less. And of course, it's a little bit more dangerous to trade when it's with a 20 cent spread, but I hope it's going to come down now. FL is up 9%. The stock that is up 9% is usually continuing higher. However, as you can see here, FL came down. Look at these bottoming tails here. There are several bottoming tails which suggests that FL is about to make a reversal. So I'm looking to go long FL. You don't want to short a stock that is up 9%. You want to go long at the first chance that you have when you have a very clear technical formation, assuming it did not go down too much. And look at the bottoming tail. So everything is looking good for a long now. It's making the move. I'm long. Okay. Long 2,000 shares in FL. Hope this is the reversal that will take it higher. NTNX is down 31%, and I love the momentum. It's a bit extended to the downside. I usually a little bit worried when I see stock that is so much extended, but it comes down with momentum. You can see that it bounced here at the VWAP, and once it did that, it may continue lower. So I'm looking to short it, just waiting for some confirmation. So far, it's trending lower, about to short 2,000 shares, shorting now just under 34.20. The lows is 33.80, so we've got some way. NTNX, I was expecting a quick move down. That did not happen. I am 2,000 shares short. I'm about to reduce 1,000. Wow, it's moving up now. Not good. Okay. I lost like $400 just on this 40 cent move up now. So I reduced my size by 1,000 shares. There's no reason to hold to a stock that is not doing what you expect it to do. I still think it's very likely to come down, but I do not want to take the risk with 2,000 shares. So just reduce, and my stop is going to be nearby. FL is not doing well. There's a very clear support line here, and it's just about to break it. I'm selling. I'm out. Well, I have a loser in FL that's like $25,000, $2,500. VUBA is great. I'm up almost 1 point, getting ready to cover 1,800 shares. Now, a little bit less than 1 point. That was a very nice trade. Finally, I have a winner after two losers. $1,200 in VUBA, but lost more than that in FL and NTNX so far. Tesla looks great. It's down 5.6%. It's trending lower. Usually, when Tesla is trending lower that much, a pullback will take it back to the highs. But some bad news in Tesla, and I like the momentum, so I'm going to take my chance at shorting it. I like the momentum. 2,000 shares under 301. Big buyers at 301 now. Just moved under 301. I'm short 2,000 shares. The lows is 299.86. That's not very far away, and I do hope to see Tesla breaking down to a new low. So far, it looks great. Just touched the lows, was very, very close. It's back over 300. Hope to see it coming back down now. Once it comes down under 300, it's very, very likely to break down under the lows. So I'm getting ready to cover 1,800 shares once it breaks down under the lows and then get a little bit more. There we go. Come on, 300, 300. Look at the buyers here. Look at the buyers. Now we're under. Look at the breakdown. That was a quick breakdown under 300 and 80 cents more. Now, first sign of a pullback. Great trade in Tesla. That's exactly what I was looking for. It continued the trend and broke down under the lows and did another 70 cents. I'm about to add to WOBA. Look at this very nice support here at the lows, 65.50, adding now at the lows because, and yes, I was right. It broke down under the lows. Sometimes I add before it breaks down. You could take a look at the buyers and the sellers and see that it had a very good chance to break down under the lows. And look at this very, very clear support. Started today at the opening price and continued later. And once it broke that down, it moved down 30 cents. So you see the low now is 65.20 and it's returning to the lows. It has a very small pullback there, which is okay. I just added 1,000 shares. And again, when I take a second trade in a stock that I'm already green in, I do not risk, here we go, getting close, bounced again. I do not risk my first trade. So I'm not taking the chance of returning into red territory with a stock that I already traded. So the entry quantity usually would be lower. Here comes the 65. Can it break down? I think I see a pullback here. No, 65 again and under and under. Oh, this is nice. Okay, took my partial. Left 300 shares in WOBA. Second good trade in WOBA today. NTNX is getting back to the 34 mark, and I really like this one. It moved up 50 cents and failed several times. Look at the number of buyers, 34. Look at the number of buyers. I'm about to short 3,000 shares, adding to my 1,000 shares that were left. Look at the number of buyers. If the number is going to drop down or under, I'm going to click the button now. Just came under 34. I click the button. I added another 3,000 shares. Now, you may remember earlier, I reduced my size by 1,000 shares, but now I have a very, very clear confirmation for a move down. Very clear confirmation. This is a huge support here at the 34 mark. And once it came down under, there are going to be a lot of sellers. The reason, very clear. The stock is down 32%. If the stock that you bought was down 34% and just broke down under the lows, you would probably have your stop loss over there. Look at this green, at this red candle over here. This extended red candle means a lot of stop orders. Almost 600,000 stocks were sold right under $34. That means fear. That means it's very likely to continue. I'm not looking at the 3,000 shares now as a continued trade. It's just a scalp for me trying to get 30 cents and I already got them. Look at 71 sellers now, 69. Any pullback, I'm going to cover. Covering now. Took a scalp. It was a very nice trade in NTNX. Just moved to a very small green territory after I lost some money with my first 1,000 shares that I reduced earlier, but turned NTNX to a green trade. And here's the end game in NTNX, up $56, Tesla $3,300, WOBA $2,200, FL a loser $3,200 in total. So I'm really having a great day. Now here's another trade that just came up in the trading room. One of my members posted it. Look at this beautiful bull flag formation over $22 there. And the intraday is a bit extended now. You can't go long over the price currently unless it pulls back down. So the only way to deal with a trade like that is to wait for it to come down a little bit. And again, look at the daily. This could be a very, very beautiful short squeeze formation. There's a lot of people who are short this stock and may move out once it moves over $22. So remember this 22 all number. Now, I want to start buying it. I want to start buying it as it pulls back down. So I don't want to buy it at the highs, which is 21.97. I'm waiting for it to come down a little bit more at around 21.80. It's very, very close now and possibly adding once it goes over the highs. If it's going to hold here, if it's going to find some support here, I'm going to buy approximately at this price right over here. Now, I'm already done with my trading day, but I can't refuse having this trade. It's going to be just fund size trade, but maybe a good lesson to learn how to scale in to a trade, because I'm not going to buy my whole quantity. Now let's assume my quantity is 400 shares. That's what I'm going to play now. Usually I would buy 4,000, but I'm going to buy 200 to start with and then add another 200 if it moves over $22. So right here, as you can see, it's holding very nicely and I'm a little bit concerned that it's going to continue higher. So I'm going to go now and buy my 200 shares here. at 2186, I'm long, and I will add if it moves over $22. So the idea is to scale into a trade which moved to a new high. You couldn't, I missed it once it moved to a new high, otherwise I may have bought it at 2180. Right now, I was waiting for it to pull back down. I never chase a stock up. It's always very, very important. You love the stock, you love the daily, you love the intraday, but you never chase it up. So I bought it at a pullback, very small size, and I'm planning to add once and if it goes over the highs, over 22. And here it comes. It's just about to move over the highs. So I only have 200 shares now, and I'm getting ready to add another 200 shares. And again, looking at the $22 number here, just remember that once the stock moves over this whole number, which may be a bit of a problem, it's very, very likely to move up on a short squeeze. There's going to be a lot of people who will close their shorts. Again, the stock, if you watch the daily earlier, moved up very strong. Look at the 22. Look at the number of sellers at 22. Huge number of sellers at 22. Look at the number. Always, all number. Wait for the number to come down. And now, you don't see so many buyers anymore, so many sellers anymore. You can click the button even before it moves 22 because it's very likely to move. Less sellers. And look at this huge breakout that happened once it moved over 22. It's at 22.30 something right now. That was a huge move. That's a short squeeze. I have 400 shares. I'm about to sell 300 shares, selling now. So just remember this trade. You don't chase a stock up. You buy when it slightly pulls back down. Yes, you may miss some great trades because they just continued moving higher, but that would be very dangerous, and there's so many fish in the sea. You don't have to go for a particular trade. So at this point over here, I was buying my first 200 shares. It could have been my whole size, my regular size, 2,000 and 8,000, but it was after I'm nicely green in the day and not taking any risks that going to jeopardize my account. So 200 shares at the first pullback, then add over the short squeeze area, which is 22 whole number. And again, a whole number, usually you would see a lot of sellers. We've seen a lot of sellers there at 22 now, at 22. And just scale into this trade as it moves higher and proves to you that it's worth scaling in. And then it moved up by 40 something cents. Click the button, take your partial and continue with 100. So thank you very much for watching this video. And please don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you want to see some more videos like this. It's right here on the right hand corner, and if you have any comments, any questions, I'll be very, very happy to answer. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks.
Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to take TradeNet's free welcome course. It was designed to teach you the basics of Wall Street trading. Click here to sign up for this no risk, no cost offer. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.